Well, hello, hello, hello. My name is Bianca. Welcome to my channel. If you're new, welcome back if you are returning. And again, I want to take just a little bit, just a small moment to thank everyone who has joined the channel, who has subscribed to my channel, those who have been subscribed from the beginning, and anyone who has spent a little bit of time with me at my channel. I greatly appreciate it. I truly do from the bottom of my heart. I never thought anyone would even be interested in anything that I was doing when I started posting about my coloring journey, especially since the topic seems to be well, for me, it was kind of like off the beaten path, you know. It's not what I usually come onto the platform for, but I have, you know, in the past year discovered that there is a really nice, vibrant adult coloring community, and that everyone is kind of like on the same page. We want to learn about color combinations. We enjoy the illustrators that are available in the market, and we're just basically having fun and relaxing and tackling our anxieties in a very healthy and productive way, in my opinion. So once again, thank you very much for your lovely comments, for your interest, and for just engaging with me in this. I don't feel so alone anymore, really. I don't feel like I'm doing it in a vacuum anymore. So I'm very, very grateful for that. So in this video, we're going to take a look at my very small RJ Hampson collection. I think I recorded this before, but it was... I recorded several videos that ended up getting corrupted, and honestly, I don't know what I said or didn't say or what I was focusing on in any of those videos before I got a chance to edit them. So the footage is pretty much crap. It got corrupted for reasons I don't know. But anyway, so in this video, I'm going to show you the titles that I have, but I'm not going to spend too much time on these because I want to get to... I've selected a few that I want to color with my Kalour pencils. That too has been requested because people want to see how the Kalour brand performs in this toothier Amazon type of RJ Hampson page. So I do have a completed page in this title, which is Moonlight Mischief. It's a really cute illustrations in this one, but I think it's a standalone title, although I think Mr. Fogarty makes an appearance in here, somewhere in here as well, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. I've seen someone color this, and this is a really pretty page. Can't wait to tackle that. Let me see if we can find Mr. Fogarty, maybe in the back. And if you don't know who Mr. Fogarty is, he already has two books all around him. He's the frog in RJ Hampson's world, and he is adorable. Huh. Oh, there, right. Mr. Fogarty right here in a wild ride. Okay, so he is in here. He tends to be a recurring character. A very fun one at that. Oh, this is very pretty. Smuggler's Island. This is nice. I wonder if I'm going to tackle them. I'm going to mark that for future coloring, maybe. All right, so I'm going to put this one away because the completed page that's in this title, I will show at the end of April. Okay, so this is another one by RJ Hampson, Oceans, and I know that I don't have anything colored in this. The Castaway . Bear with me, folks. Here it is. Wrong choice. This character also appears in several of the titles as well. I know in Lost and Found, he kinda is getting rescued. Here's the same island again for the Castaway. Surrounded by pirates at this time. Oh my god, Skull and Bones. Did he die in this one? Treasure Island. I would like to see a book dedicated to the castaway as well. That would be fun. I wonder how many scenes could be depicted on this little island for the castaway. Anyway, so this is Oceans. And this is one of my favorites, A Frog's Tale. And I have selected an image in this one that I think we could tackle. This is the second set of pages in this book from RJ. But this is the only one of this one. So this is a possibility to color. And so if you're new to RJ Hampson, his books are, you get two copies of the books. I think there's like 20 plus pages in the first half, and they're repeated in the second half. They used to be identical, but I think he's changing it up a little bit. See, he's changing it up a little bit. From section to section, and in the back section for most of them, the same image will have a black background. So that's kind of how he does that. But we have one possibility to color in here, and I love this book. I don't think I've done anything in it. I have not. So here's the second Mr. Fogarty coloring book. This is, see, A Frog's Tale is a Mr. Fogarty coloring book, and so is this one. So the main character is this one. This one came out first, and then this is a recent release for Mr. Fogarty. And there's lovely ones in this one too, and I think I selected this one. So this is a possibility for us to color and try and show you how the Kalour pencils work. This is probably gonna win. All right, so I'm gonna put these two aside here because I think I'm gonna definitely pick one of those two. And this is also a new release, 2024 release, Serendipity. I think it's 2024. Oh my gosh. Oh, it was first published in 2023 and I bought it in 2024. Okay, but this one's called Serendipity, and there's various characters in this one. There's an attempt at nature mandalas, kind of like Melpomene with nature's mandalas, and it's really, really, everything he does is really nice. Oh, Mr. Fogarty again. This one is called The Sunshine is a Glorious Birth. What a pretty page. So another one that I don't have anything colored in. This is a Christmas one by RJ Hampson that has in the back. You can copy these, photocopy these, and create your own little Christmas village with these. You can paint them. I mean, paint them. Well, yeah, I guess depending on the material that you print it on, you can color and paint them, and it's you're supposed to create like a little village. 14, there are 14 models for you to set up to construct and color. I haven't done anything on this. I purchased this to color like Christmas themes for that time of the season, and you know, if you've been here a minute, you know that I wasn't doing so well in 2023. Oh, Mr. Fogarty had. Mr. Fogarty makes an appearance here as well. Oh my gosh, he's everywhere. Ah, he's so cute. Okay, but you know, it was supposed to be for a Christmas coloring that I wanted to do, and I was just so tired from the treatment that I didn't get to it, but hopefully maybe this year. Lost and Found is another one. I think I may have something done in here. Let me see. Oh, Mr. Fogarty, is this like a bicycle, but like in the old, yeah, this is a bicycle. Forget what this type of bicycle is called. Here's the castaway again. We don't know if he's being rescued. He's cute. But this is another one that I would like to do in this particular coloring book. So I'm going to put this one aside because this is a third option to do with the Kalour pencils. All right. So as you can see, my RJ Hampson collection is very small. He's got other titles, but these are the ones that I like the most. This one is Night Garden, and this is one of the first RJ Hampson books that I purchased last year. And I know this is done with Kalour pencils, but I didn't write it down. Oh no, I did. This is done June 18, 2023 with Kalour pencils. Yes, I did. So this is one of the more successful pages that I've managed to do just in pencils alone. This took me about a week and a half to complete. And I truly, truly think it came out really well. There was a few things that I wanted to accomplish with this, since it was supposed to be like a sunset or sunrise theme. And I was trying to practice to get that like golden-y glow in the trees, on the sides of the trees where the light would come in from behind the cabin. So I was trying to, like, instead of shadows, I was trying to do lights and things like that. And it was really beautiful. I mean, I truly enjoyed it. And so we're going to try to do this quality again with Kalour when we finally pick a page that we want to do for the color along. This one is Forest Song. And I have this one, which you'll probably see again because at the end of April, I am going to show you all of my completed pages that I've done for the whole year. So, oh, this is a nice one too. So you can see RJ has Mr. Fogarty. Mr. Fogarty takes a break. Has I like his line, the thickness of his line work. And he is very, very whimsical. And you do get two chances to color a page. If you mess one up, well, then you get another chance. That is if, like, I have a printer, but I never use it for this purpose. You know what I mean? Because I would love to get Mr. Fogarty again. Portobello Road is this one. I would love to get, I think it's the Nina paper, or something like that. I forget what it's actually called. Lucy Just Adds Color has talked about that cardstock paper. And she uses it to, you know, so you can have a thicker stock on it, and you can use different types of mediums versus this like really thin paper where I would not use wet media on this, like the gouache and the watercolors that I like to use. You might be able to get away with using markers, either alcohol markers or water-based markers, but that's not my favorite media at all, and I don't use them. I don't even own them. I do have like metallic types so that I can do embellishments, but I don't have like actual markers, like water-based or alcohol-based markers. I don't. I did get the satin glazing liquid, but I've tested this on other pages. I still have to experiment a little bit more before I actually put this to a page that I like, because it crinkled it too much, just way too much, and I don't want to ruin it. So when I get my application process down, that's when I will use this on RJ Hampson's Amazon printed pages, so that, you know, we can use more medias like the Hemi gouaches, the Neo Color 2s and so forth, and the King Art sticks, the Sargent Art sticks, the ones that I really do like to use to make my coloring a little easier and so that it's easier on my hands. That having been said, Kalour works really nice, at least for me it does, on this type of book. On RJ's books, works really, really nice, as you can see from the Night Song. It works really, is it for a song? No, it's for a song in Night Garden. As you can see in my page in Night Garden, it works really, really well. I love it. I think it's nice and vibrant. I'm not unhappy with Kalour on this paper at all. So, I'm going to stop here. I'm going to set up everything. I think I'm going to use the 300 set that I have. And we're going to pick a page and just get on with it. See you in a sec. Okay, guys. We are going to play around in this one with my 300 Kalour pencil set. As you can see, I have not swatched every single one. I just kind of tend to swatch them as I go to see if it's a kind of tone or shade that I want while I'm coloring. The 300 set has metallics and has neons to it. It may even also have some pastels. I do have the metallic and pastel sets individually. I think there's like 52 of those in each, if I'm not mistaken. Let me pull that out just for references, I think, so that you can see. I think I have them in here. Yes. Okay, there's 50, not 52. So this is the macaroon set here. I do have it. And on this side, I believe, is where I have the metallics. And I've actually taken the time to swatch all of these. I got to get on the macaroons, I think. So I do own they're 50 each for metallic and macaroons. And I do own those sets. And they're just as buttery, in my opinion, as the regular set. Now, I originally started out with the 72 set of pencils for Kalour. At the time, I think I paid only like $13 on Amazon when they were first coming out. Now, I think they're a little bit more now because, you know, they've become more popular. And so when anything becomes more popular, instead of decreasing the price because people buy more of it, they just increase the prices. Doesn't make sense in a capitalist thing, if you know anything about economics, but hey, you know, we are living in a capitalist dystopia. So when things become popular, people just end up paying more. But however, it's not that prohibitive. Anyway, even though they increased the prices a little bit, they're still considered to be budget pencils, and I do love them very, very much. Of course, nothing in the world beats the higher end pencils, but these come, I think, in my opinion, in my experience, in my humble experience, they're almost not as soft as my Prismacolor set, but these are a good alternative to go to as far as softness. And for somebody who has problems, like because of my medication and things like that, I have a much easier time using these than any of my other budget sets. So they feel like Prismas to me. They almost, let's not get crazy, but almost. So for that alone and for the price that they were, it's worth it to me to have like way more shades than what I have in my Prismas. So I do like that. I do like to have lots and lots and lots and lots of choices as far as colors and tones and shades go. I know some people don't particularly care for that. They want to have like a curated set, and that's fine. But for me, I'm a bit of a color glutton, and I love more choices. So I put my 300 pencil set in this case here that I did purchase from Amazon. And I do it by color family, regardless of whether it's warm or cool end of the spectrums for that particular color. So I tend to put my greens together, my purples and blues together, pinks going into oranges and reds, and then I have my neutrals, my skin tones, and my different shades of gray, whether they be cool gray, warm grays, greens, green based or purple or blue based grays, all of my grays together, along with all of my different browns, and I even include most of my metallics in the neutrals. It's just the way I like to have it. I like to have it distributed. It's easier for me to find something. And what's nice about this particular case that I got on Amazon is that it has the individual slots for each pencil. It's something you need to pay attention to, because I have a case here that I also purchased in Amazon. It's very pretty. I like it. But one of the things that you don't realize with some of these, or at least I didn't, I have my Cool Bank pencils in here, but these have slots that can hold up to, let me see, these slots here can hold up to 3 pencils at a time, and it's just, I don't really care for that. I prefer to have individual slots for individual pencils instead of trying to shove 3 pencils into one slot. It holds it pretty well. It can do two pencils in each slot as well, and the pencil will stay put. But I like this, the individual slots, much better, because it lets me know where a pencil came from, from which slot a pencil came from that I have pulled out. And this is kind of, well, there's 3 pencils in one slot. Sometimes I'll have only 2 pencils in one slot. And it kind of throws me off as far as my organization purposes and my undiagnosed ADHD or whatever it is that I have that makes me so fussy about things. So it's not wrong, but it's just like not desirable for me. I like to have individual slots. That having been said, I do own it, and I have my Cool Bank pencils on there, you know, or in that case, and we're good. Okay, we'll live. That's not a big deal. All right, so this is a big monstrous case, as you can see. So I am going to pick the color stories for the different elements, which we're going to do this page. I think I ultimately decided on this one. And this would be the first page that I've colored in this particular book since it's new in my collection. And I think I want to follow more or less. I'm going to use the cover as inspiration for the characters. I may reverse some things. I may add a few other colors. But I'm going to select up to at least 3 pencils for each of the little elements that we have to start off with, and so that I can rescue some of my space, because this is a very small desk that I have to color on, and I'll be right back. We'll show you what those are in a sec. Alrighty guys, let me put you in position here. So I've selected a few colors to start with. This is, of course, not going to be all the colors we're going to use in the page, because there are other elements, but I wanted to concentrate first on the two main characters, which is Mr. Fogarty, and I believe his name is Mr. Snail. I have to find out. I don't know what his faithful companion's name is. It's in one of the books. I'm sure we're going to come across it at some point. Mr. Fogarty and Snail. There it is. Yep, just Snail. He doesn't get a mister. I don't know why. They're at the Taj Mahal. Mr. Fogarty meets a fellow passenger. There's cute ones in this one, really, really. Okay, so Mr. Fogarty, and I'm going to give him a mister. Mr. Snail. Out of respect. We picked the colors for them. All right, let me see if I can... We need maybe this one. Yeah, that might be a little better. Not by much, but there we go. All right, so I've picked color combinations for the different elements that we're going to start out with first. Excuse me, I have to cough. Sorry about that. So, and I've kind of... And this, is from the Kalour 300 set. And I've sort of separated them into color stories for the different elements. I'm not sure how well these are going to show up in camera, but some of these are kind of light on camera, and I'm putting it against the white paper, which is like these parts over here. And I'm repeating some of the, choosing some of the colors for different elements between the characters, just to tie them in the color stories. This Mr. Snail's body is kind of the same color as the belt and the hat, and there's some highlight colors that kind of hint to the clothing of Mr. Fogarty and so forth. I may add a little bit of green somewhere to Mr. Snail, maybe the eyes, in order to tie him in with his buddy, with his traveling buddy, because I like those kinds of tie-ins. So anyway, let's begin, and I think, let's look at the image. So the coat's a little different in this image than the one he has here. This one is striped, and this one is not, and I plotted for the striped coat. Oh, but the pants are striped. Okay, reversal, I guess. So let's start with the pants. Let's keep it simple. When I'll take a picture of this and post it, and post it along with the video so that you can pick out colors similar to, or if you happen to have the Kalour pencil set, then you'll kind of see the color story. You can pick it out by the numbers. Alrighty, so let's just start. Let me bring you in a little closer. We're going to do those pants. In the color story that I had originally thought was going to be for the coat. It doesn't matter, it's still going to be the same. So we have light stripes and dark stripes. Okay, so we have decided that zero 013 is burnt brick red, and 034 is brick dust. All right, so we're gonna do those, and I'm gonna start with the lightest one. We are going to start right here. I'm going to try to match each side. I'm not even putting that much pressure, even though I'm kind of close to the barrel. I mean, to the edge there. And as you can see, it's really lovely. When you put more pressure, you can really darken up that color. I always like to start as light as possible and then darken as needed to create my shadows and highlights and so forth, just to give myself some leeway. And I don't even have to put that much pressure in order to get a good pigmentation. They're really kind of, they're very creamy. I like Kalour on this type of paper. Can do really, really light. And you can, as you can see, start darkening very easily and very quickly. They're very pigmented. I like them. They're not stingy. And okay, so the little cups are mixed with that. And let me see. I'm not so sure that I'm going to like that too much. 280. I'm going to add 287 here. Let's see if that looks really a little bit better with this combination. No, it's a little too light. This is definitely for Mr. Snail. But we can use a little bit, I think, of the cream yellow, which is 056. And this way you can see how nicely I'm sorry, battery died in the midst of a critical point in the coloring, which is me trying to show you how well they actually blend together and how you can layer them up. So here we go. We're going to add a little bit of this color here, just a little bit, so it's not so clashing in my eyes. I might have done this a little too dark, but okay, whatever. I like that better. It looks like it belongs to the pants. Alrighty. So as you can see, they're very easy to mix. That's three colors right there, which is this 034 Brick Dust. I believe I used the Ice Gray 287. And then we put a little bit more warmth to that with the cream yellow 056. So that's for the little I don't know what you call this. It's the part of the pants that you fold up. It's not a cuff, right? Cuffs are only for wrists, right? Can you tell I don't know anything about fashion? Anyway, if you know what this is supposed to be called in English, let me know. Hopefully you can see it. And see how nice it is. Let me get you in. So we've matched the pants to the coat using the color scheme that we chose. All right, so that means that for this solid color, we wanted to do the 202 and 287. So we're going to do the coat. Here's a little coat, and then we'll think about, I don't think I can see any undershirt under the, in the cover. I do not. So that's what 202, which is this beautiful color, I believe. Yes, this is called an orange gray. And then the 287 for highlights, which is called ice gray. So we're gonna do those for Mr. Fogarty's. And I'm sorry if I'm off camera or anything. I'm not paying attention to the view screen. I should from now on, since I'm trying to show you how these Kalour pencils work. All right, so orange gray 202. No more messing around. Let's do it. I'm going to start from here, and I'm going to put a light layer first. It's good to start light when you're not entirely, when you haven't entirely taken in the element itself. Like, there's a lot of little things around in here that I'm not focusing on just yet, and I don't want to color something that isn't part of the actual coat. Like, you see this little element here. This is a pocket, and it is part of the coat. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in, or include that. And I'm scrumpling, which is circular movements on the page. For coloring this is fine. I like this movement. It just gives me less lines. And of course, it depends on how sharp your point is. You may actually get a whole bunch of circular lines if you do it too hard. So try to, if you're unsure where you're going to put your shadows, if you even like the color you're starting out with, do a light layer first. I'm going to do this part right in here. This is, I think, is part of the inside shirt, so I'm not going to leave that because I don't know what color I want to do that just yet. Okay, and now I'm going to tackle areas where I think my shadows should be, which I'm going to do it a little bit, give it a little bit more pressure to see what that looks like and to see if I'm even right. Sometimes you put shadows in areas where it's like, okay, that doesn't make sense there. So if you do it lightly, you can in fact correct either by erasing or by making everything a similar tone and then putting your shadows even darker where you think they should have gone instead, or where you want the new place where you want them to go. And I'm still going very, very light. I'm not putting a whole lot of pressure. I'm just building up those areas and preserving my lightest areas. Seeing it's starting to take a little bit of a shape there. It's not so flat. That's kind of how I like to color. It's easier for me to create a 3D dimension or the illusion of one with pencils than it is with markers. I can also do this with watercolor gouaches just because they reactivate. And I think that's probably one of the reasons why I have not made an investment into the Derwent ink tents, I think it is. I think once you activate those, and once they dry, that's it. It's permanently on the page. Correct me if I'm wrong, I think that's what the deal is. And can I tell you, that scares the crap out of me because I just changed my mind so much. I have to be able to... I need some leeway, you know what I mean? I need some give. And I don't think that the ink tents pencils are very forgiving. I think that's for like a level way, way, way above mine. Shell from Shell's Corner, I'll leave a link. She uses a lot of ink tents, and she does she does color alongs on there, and I think she uses the ink tents. I'm suspecting it's her. She's very brave. If it's the one that I'm thinking of, she's very brave to color with. I think people who color with those types of pencils and markers in general are really kind of brave. because once you put that on the page, that's it, you're done. And the only way to correct it is like with acrylic, you know what I mean? It's just, I don't want to go through all that hassle. So I tend to choose mediums that are a little bit more forgiving for me, because I'm a spaz. And I change my mind right in the middle of actually doing things. I'll be coloring and then I change my mind. So. So you see what I mean? It's really, really nice. And let me... It's almost, you know, once you put these two colors down, they're not, it's not that much of a difference. It's still kind of within the same family. This ice gray 287 kind of gets lost. So I don't think I accomplished too much with selecting this one. It looks so much different when you swatch it out. But when you color with it like I'm doing right now, it doesn't seem to like really add too much. It's not that much of a color difference. So I think I kind of changed my mind about this one. We're going to have to maybe add a little bit of yellow onto that. Let's see. Let me pick up this rice yellow 242. Let me see if that'll give it... It may be too light already. This might be too light. It gave it a little bit of a beige tone. It's not that bad. Versus a flat gray tone, but it's not the best. Okay. Let's see here. It by itself would do something. Me. Not really. Okay, maybe some of this cream yellow 056. Oh, that's giving it a little bit of a tone there where it doesn't look so neutral. Are you seeing that? Oh yeah, that gives it a little bit of a different hint there. A warmer hint. I'm liking that. Yeah, that works for me. And the little accent areas of the coat. Oops. Coloring outside the lines. Oh yeah, that looks a little bit better. It looks more there. Let's see if I'm gonna mess this up royally and put this one aside. And maybe add a little bit of that brick dust 034. Just a little bit. In the shadows, just a wee bit to match it, to kind of tie it in with the pants a little bit. Just where we have the little details. I'm going, not doing it too harshly. Oh yeah, that looks much nicer. Okay, so I'm gonna use this like as a shadow tone here. And I'm doing it very lightly. Good little corners there. Come back in here. Whoops. Like back in here. A little bit and up here. Like that. Maybe a little bit close to the rose right here, or the little flower that Mr. Fogarty is wearing, and it gives it a little bit more dimension. Yeah, and it doesn't look so flat. I like that. All right, so while we're at it, I'm going to finish the coat here with the orange gray 202, and then I'm also going to do the hat. Okay, so it's going to be the same color scheme matching the coat. So I'll see you guys back in a sec. Alrighty, so we're back. I finished the hat, and just with the orange gray 202, and then I did the band in the two colors that the pants are made of, which is the burnt brick red. These two right here, and the brick dust. Okay, so that's a 013 and 034 respectively, if you happen to have the same set. So he's looking real dapper and real nice, and I really like that. I'm not sure what color I'm going to do this cane, but it's probably going to match the outfit in and of itself. But right now I want to move on to Mr. Snail. I'm really curious to see how we are going to do the body and the shell. He's gonna definitely echo Mr. Fogarty, but I think I want to start out with the body itself, because it's kind of like these gray tones that match the hat. It might be a little bit of a purpley undertone to it, which is why I picked that eggplant gray. So we're doing 295, 202, 195, which is the lotus gray, and then we have the 287, which is the ice gray, for a little bit of accents, but it's turning out not to be quite the way I wanted it. So this might be replaced with one of the more warmer tones, either the rice yellow or the cream yellow. We'll see. We're gonna start out first with 195, which is the lotus gray, and for the lighter portions, which is probably this here and the top portions there. We'll see. Let's see the angle. And I'm going to do a very, very light, very lightly there. All right. Now that we got you closer, let's see how it goes. Right here seems to be something of a lighter spot. Right here. And right here. And also, I think the underbelly is actually quite light as well. So we're going to do the underbelly and this portion right here. And I don't know that that's going to pick up too much on camera, because it really is kind of light. It's a very light cream color. All right, we're going to put that one aside. Let's start working with that 202 orange gray. Okay. Not too bad. Still looks kind of light. That's okay. Now we're going to do that eggplant 295. And I'm using these as a deepening color. Like that.
Let's try a little bit more here. And a little bit more highlights right in here for this spots, for the spots and so forth. Back to the mid-tone, so it's not so odd, like that. Yeah, that's not bad. Alrighty, now let's get to Mr. Snail's shell, and we decided that we are going to do the Burnt Brick Red, which is 013. Oh, nope, nope. No, we did not. Let's see. I'm reading the wrong place. We're going to go for Indian Red, which is a 026. That's going to be that russet color. Then 034 is going to be the Brick Dust again. And then the 056, which I believe is this cream yellow. Those are going to be the three choices for the snail. And again, we're going to start with the lightest color and we're going to work our way to the darkest color. Now, all right, so this is going to be a little bit tricky because in this particular image and the angle that they have Mr. Snail in, whoops, we only have a certain amount of space to put the highlight to make it look like a caracol. I don't know how you say that in English. A little rounded, a curly type shell. In Spanish, it's called caracol, which is a word that alludes to a curl. All right, let's do the mid one here. I'm going to put it next to that. We're going very lightly first so that we don't mess it up too badly, because I'm not sure about the illusion and how that's going to turn out. So I'm going lightly, putting it right next to it. I don't want to lose the highlight. We'll do the same thing right in here. And we're going to do the darker points right in here. Back to the lightest one, and we're going to try to blend all of that together. I'm going to try to highlight some of the sections here. Don't know that it makes a difference, but there we go. Alrighty, guys, Mr. Fogarty and Mr. Snail. Alrighty, so the next thing I want to do here is I'm going to, you know what? Mr. Snail has eyebrows that are floating in the air. We're going to give those some definition and we're going to make it the deepest burnt orange there. I just noticed that his floating eyebrows. Okay, I know I want to make his eyes kind of green, but I don't want to do the whole eyeball green, so I'm going to hold off on that. And we're going to concentrate on Mr. Fogarty himself. All right, so He is, according to the little legend that we have here, 135, which is a forest green, and it's kind of a bright green. 282, which is, I think, which is 282? It's 287, that's not it. These numbers are so hard to read. Oh, there it is, 282. Because they're in that platinum, or they got that metallic to them. They're very hard to read. So 282, which is a pear green. 135, which this one here is a forest green. And 242, it's one of these light colors. Did I not pull it out? Oh, there it is. 242, which is the rice yellow. I didn't even recognize it. It looks so different on paper than it does on the barrel. This is why they tell you to go on ahead and swatch things, because the color of the barrel doesn't necessarily match the pigment in that it contains. So it catches you by surprise. But anyway, these are the three colors that we'll want to use for Mr. Fogarty. And he also has like a much lighter underbelly here in the palms of the hands and in the greens. And in the webbing right in here. So we're going to start with the lightest color. I'm not seeing palms of the hands, but we can do like the little nubs of the fingers. We can do the little nubs here. And we're going to do the chin area very lightly. And it goes up to the cheeky area here. So we can do that. Are his lips light? Kinda, but not really. Well, so I'm gonna put an even lighter coat on his lips. Alright, so the next color in is this one. And it's kinda like a little bit over that. Here we go for the hands. I hope I've been in frame. Oh, I don't think I was in frame for the feetsies. I'm sorry. So, you know, we did this. I'm gonna have to look up into the screen. I'm sorry. As you can tell, I don't do these very often, so I'm learning. Bear with me. Have patience. All right, let me get that face in frame. We're gonna be leaving this part here in the chin area a lot lighter. We're just adding kind of like a green tint to things. And this is the mid portion or the mid tone. And I am going to go a little bit over the lips as well, because they're not that light on the cover photo. Okay, now we're going for Brooke, folks. Let's start with the feet again and get those in frame. And let's see if I made a good decision with this forest green, because it's kind of it's kind of scary. Here we go. Let's start from the back here. It might tone down a bit since I have all of these like olivey greens, light yellows. It may not read as bright as it is on its own. Let me take a look at these webbed feet again. So yes. Alright, so he's got a little bit of shadowing here at the tootsies. The little nubbies here. And let's add a little bit of dimension right in here. Or his little fitsies, and I'm going to go a little bit dark. So I do that with a little bit of pressure. Foot number one, I think. Little nubbies right in here. right in there. Okay, repeat. Alrighty, that looks pretty cool. We are going to now go for the hands. Once you are okay with where you're putting your greens, you can start deepening up to create a little bit of dimension, like that, more or less. And now for the face. Close to the collar, we're going to add some of that pretty green, but we're still going to keep that area kind of light. Let me see for the little nose. It's more of a lighter green. So you want to let some of that pretty little lighter yellow coming through in some of the areas intermixed with the green. And I want to give some definition to where his lips are. Just a little bit on his little nose and his eyeballs. So I hope this was a good sample. As you can see how the Kalour pencils, how easy it is to color in RJ Hampson's and any Amazon paper that you may have, any coloring book printed on that Amazon paper that's a little bit toothier and thin. You can see that, you know, the Kalours work wonderful, I think, in this paper. And you can get really nice results with it. I mean, you can go from really light to really dark. They layer upon each other. They mix well with each other when you're using two or three different colors. I've gone all the way up to 5 different color pencils with these, as far as layering goes, and I get really nice results with it. Kalour pencils also work really nicely in Hannah Carlson's books as well. So I'm not going to make this video too long. I just wanted to give a sample, you know, to show you how well the Kalour pencils do work. Like I said, I'm going to take a picture of this. We didn't get to the watch here. The watch is on the ground, and I picked, wait a minute, the 215 and 099, which is the gold ones. Let's see. Before we go, this is a metallic one, which is the 215. It's a metallic. And it's really nice. I like their metallics. Look how easy it's just doing the job. I'm not even putting that much pressure, and it's just putting the pigment down. I really do like these pencils. I don't have to work too hard at all. Oops, I didn't pick for the center, so I'm just going to do it this color. It doesn't matter because later on I can do more in 099. The first one was 215, which was the metallic gold, and then the 099 was this earth tone to give it some depth. And look how easy it does that. Just like that. I absolutely love these pencils in these books. It's just really easy to accomplish things. All right, guys, that's it for now. I'm going to complete this page off camera, and it will be included in the next video or the video after that.
For everything that I've colored in the month of April, including everything that I've done so far in my first year of coloring. So it's going to be like a twofer. So I'll see you guys then. Take care and stay safe while you're out doing your good in the world. See you next time. Bye.